Today I'll be recapping episodes 33 through 35 of Eternal Love. Yehua finishes his meeting with Diefeng and meets back up with Bai Qian and Ali. He saves Bai Qian from a random drunk guy, teleporting him to who knows where for touching his fiancée. When Bai Qian claims a little touching is no big deal, he freezes the world for a second, giving her a kiss to prove his point. That night, their hotel room is attacked by Ghost Tribe puppets again, but Yehua scares them off. The Heavenly Lord is hosting a birthday banquet. Yehua leaves Ali with Bai Qian and makes his way to the event. Sangji has been allowed to attend the banquet with his eldest son, Yuanzhen. The relationship between Sangji and the Heavenly Lord is still strained, but he seems to like his grandson at least a little. Cue Sujin. Her new plan is to pretend Yuanzhen tried to rape her. With such a huge thing happening to his consort, Yehua will have to stay in the Celestial Tribe for a few days. That's it. That's her plan. It works, since Yuanzhen is very young and innocently follows her into her room. Sujin fakes the almost rape and presents herself to the Heavenly Lord, who takes her side and punishes Yuanzhen with a trial in the mortal realm. He will only be able to return as an immortal if he passes the trial. In private, Yehua makes it clear that he knows she faked it and has ruined yet another life. At this point, I feel like Yehua gets some of the blame for continuing to let her live, knowing how crazy she is, but anyway. It's been 2 years since Feng Zhou arrived in the mortal realm, and she finally gets to meet with Emperor Dijin. She's open and loving with him, and they hit it off. He tells her about his beloved consort who became a nun after giving birth to their son Yuanzhen. If you're wondering about the name, yes, this is Yuanzhen of the Celestial Tribe, memory erased and sent to the mortal realm. His trial just happens to be as Emperor Dijin's son, but again, no one knows who anyone is. Yehua decides that if Bai Qian has really lost her memory, he will simply start over with her. Xiaoxing comes to the fox den to see Bai Qian and cash in her favor. She asks Bai Qian to help Yuanzhen pass his mortal trial, reasoning that the Heavenly Lord will turn a blind eye to it since it's her. Bai Qian agrees to help, though she reminds her that this will end their relationship. Yehua consults Siming to find out Yuanzhen's fate. One day, a bird will scare a woman into a river. Yuanzhen will save her and fall in love. Then, the Emperor will take a liking to the woman and marry her. Yuanzhen and the woman will continue to meet in secret until the woman has a son. It's Yuanzhen's son, though he doesn't know it. When the Emperor dies, Yuanzhen will fight the son for control of the throne and kill him. The woman then hangs herself, leaving him a letter explaining what he's done. Yuanzhen lives for another 30 or so miserable years. This is a wild fanfiction tale written by Siming. I'd love to read some of his other works. Bai Qian plans to go down disguised as Yuanzhen's teacher and try to make it so he never meets this woman. Miaoqing overhears the plan and relays it to Sujin, who instructs Miaoqing to follow Bai Qian to the mortal realm. Yehua sees the picture and puts together that Siyin is Bai Qian. Bai Qian goes down and meets Yuanzhen. The ill-fated couple is meant to meet in 6 months, giving her plenty of time. At the Ghost Tribe, Xuanyu is still holding on to the body of her dead child. During an argument, Li Jing reveals to Xuanyu that Bai Qian is Siyin. With this news, Xuanyu quickly puts together that Bai Qian must have Mo Yan's body. She disguises herself as Bai Qian, tricking a servant into leading her to Mo Yan's body. She steals his body along with Ali. Yehua goes to see Bai Qian and suggests that she distract Yuanzhen and push Dijin into the river. This should prevent Yuanzhen's fate. Anytime an immortal acts to change a mortal's fate, they receive retribution from the heavens, so Bai Qian wants Sangji to do it since it's his son. Fair enough. Yehua definitely didn't come just to talk business though, and that night they sleep together. Sleep next to each other. The next day, Bai Qian goes to see Feng Zhou, but allows her to stay and carry out her Dijin fantasy. Xuanyu has brought Mo Yan and Ali back to the Ghost Tribe and plans to use their bodies to exchange for her child's life. This is also why she has been sending out puppet soldiers. She has been trying to get the body of a high immortal. Zhe Yan is invited to the West Sea after the West Sea Lord's oldest son, Diefeng's older brother, falls ill. The big day arrives, and as planned, a bird appears and tosses a beautiful woman into the water. Bai Qian distracts Yuanzhen, while Sangji appears briefly to push mortal Dijin into the water. Feng Zhou dives in after to save him, causing him to fall more in love with her. Miaoqing tries to push Bai Qian into the water, but luckily Yehua was watching and saves her. Sujin's plans are the worst. They're just so short-sighted and unnecessarily cruel. What in the world goes through this girl's head? And what irritates me the most is that every time she gets some comeuppance, she always has that expression on her face that says,
"What? What did I do to deserve this?"
How do you not know, Sujin? Till next time, thanks for watching.